Hi guys, my name is Mirka and I'm your Italian tutor. Welcome back for a new listening activity. But remember, if you're new to my YouTube channel, remember to subscribe. Or if you're already a subscriber, click the notification bell, because every time I make a video, you are going to be notified. So for today, we're going to do a listening activity. So, for this activity, I recommend you to put earplugs and listen this audio 3 times. Because it's not a video, it's just an audio. And you're going to hear 2 different accents. One is mine, obviously, from the north, and one from the south. And we are going to play a game after, which is to answer true or false. But if you want to try, or if you are an advanced level of Italian, please correct the false and write a small sentence in the comment section below. We are going also to learn new vocabulary, so it's really important to listen carefully. Let's go!
Hello. Pronto? Trattoria La Gemma del Sud.
Buonasera, sono il signor Rossi. Volevo prenotare un tavolo per stasera. Avete disponibilità?
Sì, a che ora vorrebbe prenotare?
Per le 8.
Perfetto. In quanti siete?
5 persone.
Perfetto. Avete qualche richiesta particolare?
Non abbiamo allergie, però c'è una vegana nel gruppo. Fate un menù vegano.
Sì, certo.
E il costo è sempre 25 euro?
Sì, sempre uguale.
Per tutti e 2 i menù, giusto?
Sì, compreso di vino, acqua e caffè.
Perfetto. No, anzi, scusi, avete disponibilità alle 8:30?
Devo guardare un attimo che controllo. Va bene, sì, per le 8:30 sì, ho un posto.
È dentro o fuori?
È fuori, nel giardino.
Va bene, perfetto. Dunque, 8:30 è 5
persone. Cioè, nella veranda, mi scusi, nel giardino.
Ok, 8:30 stasera per 5 persone.
Ok, perfetto. La ringrazio di aver chiamato. A stasera, arrivederci.
Grazie molto. So the question that you have to answer are: il tavolo è prenotato per 5 persone. Vero o falso? Il signor Rossi cambia la prenotazione dalle 8 alle 8:30. Vero o falso? Il menù fisso costa 20 euro. Vero o falso? C'è un'opzione vegetariana ma non vegana. Vero o falso? Ok, before I give you the answer, I'm going to go through some vocabularies that I think they're really, really important. So, 2 important verbs, prenotare. Prenotare means to book, and you can use it to prenotare una stanza, un ristorante, un tavolo, un locale, if you're rich. And then telefonare. Be careful on telefonare, because telefonare is followed by an indirect object pronoun. You can say, io telefono a Maria, o io le telefono. If you want to review the lesson on that, please link above and rewatch it. There are some restaurants that are going to offer you menu fisso or menu alla carta, a fixed menu, so basically, or a set menu, where you're going to choose between 2 or 3 main course and second dishes, okay? Menu alla carta means that you open your menu and you choose whatever you like. Obviously, the price are going to be different. Un menu fisso, you're going to pay a set amount of money and you're going to have that. If you pay alla carta, you can pay a lot of money or less. It depends what you like. So let's have a look on the menu. So you're going to have antipasti, starter, primi piatti, main course, secondi piatti, second course, dessert, dolce. Drinks, you can have vino,
birra,
una bibita. La bibita can be like a fizzy drink. So you can have Coca-Cola, aranciata, Sprite, I think everywhere. For water, you're going to hear different words to indicate when it's still or sparkly. So related to still, for example, you can say naturale is the most common one, or liscia, okay? Sparkling water, you can say gassata, frizzante, minerale, con gas, I heard in some restaurants, con bolle, especially if you're talking with a child, vuoi l'acqua con le bolle o l'acqua normale? Okay. Related to menu, so you can have, for example, vegetariano. So vegetariano and vegano are adjectives, so change if they're related to. They can be masculine, feminine, singular and plural. So, for example, io sono vegetariano. Loro sono vegani. Lei non è vegana, ma vegetariana. Okay? I think that is very important if you book in the restaurant, especially if you have allergies, is to specify what kind of allergies do you have. So you're going to say, io sono allergico a ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. So for example, io sono allergico al latte. Io sono allergico al kiwi. Ok? We don't usually tip the waiter or waitress, but if you want to do it, it's appreciated. If you tip me, I'll take it. Very interesting to know. When you go to the restaurant, remember that on the bill, you're going to see coperto. Coperto means basically it's like a table tax, if we can say like that, and it can be per person or per table. But mainly, I saw in the restaurant that it's per person, which can be maybe 50p. 1 euro. An important thing, especially if you're English, American, but the level of service can be a little bit different. So it can be straightforward. We are always polite, but it can be straightforward and it can sound sometimes rude. But actually, we are not in that instance, but because it's direct, we want to serve you as quick as possible and that you enjoy your meal. However, for example, it's something that when I was there, I never seen. The complaint part is completely different. So if you order food and if you don't like it, you ask the waiter to change it or etc. There is no such a thing that you finish your meal and then when you go to pay, you're going to complain like to give the feedback and maybe you're going to get a discount. It doesn't really work like that. So if you have any problem, you have to let the waiter or the owner know straight away. Once when I used to work as a waiter, there was this couple where they order like an amount of food that it's like industrial amount of food, and then when they went to pay, they tried to be cheeky and say, "Yeah, but I didn't like this. This one wasn't very enjoyable. I want a discount." But the owner said, "Did you tell me at that moment? No, I'm sorry. This is the price." So don't get offended if it's like that, but this is the way we do it. Because for us, this is the reason also that we go to a restaurant. Maybe we really didn't enjoy it, but it can be maybe because it's me, maybe I'm not in the mood, so I don't fancy that part, or I expect a big portion of tiramisu and maybe it's a small one, but you're going to pay because you ate it at the end of the day, okay? Have any question, please share in the comment section below. I really hope that you enjoyed this listening activity and see you in the next lesson. Bye for now.